In this video, I'm going to show you how to maneuver around my online amp catalog in my web store here. It's pretty easy, but some people get confused, not sure why. But anyways, this is the HoffmanAmps.com homepage. Clicking on any of these scrolling images up here can get you into a catalog page, like that'll take you to the resistors page. Down here is a table, take in all the pages. So let's just go to a page. Let's go to pots and knobs here. Okay. And here's what seems to confuse people sometimes is, how do you get to your shopping cart if you already have stuff in your shopping cart? Look right here. Click here to open the catalog index. View your shopping cart. There you are. Search the parts catalog. Here's where you log in and log out if you've already set up a username and password. In a, you can only do that checking out from a previous order, and then your sales totals are saved and you can get discounts. So here's where you log in and log out right there. Here's a list of all the parts lists that I have. If you're a mobile user, you'll get a friendlier looking screen that fits on mobile pages like this. And down here is view your shopping cart. And let's go back to the non-mobile. So open here, go to a page. Let's go to anyone here, fuses, cords, AC. Let me add a fender fuse holder. These are all the parts. This is how you add a part, change the quantity. Say you want two of these, add it to your parts list. So here's my shopping cart. I've already added a couple things. Let's go around this screen here and show you what you can do. Let's say I want to change the quantity of this Jupiter cap up here. I want three of them. So enter three, hit update. Now I have three and the price has been extended. Let's say I want to delete this board here. I'm going to put zero. Update. Now it's gone. Now this text here explains all the things the update button does. Change a quantity, enter a new quantity, and press update. I just explained that. Remove an item, change quantity zero, press update. Just explain that. If you have board material and other things, there'll be a checkbox. Let's go quick and go up to here. Let's go to board building parts. I'm going to add some glass epoxy board to my shopping cart. I'm going to get quantity 1, 12-inch board. Let's get 12.5 inches. I want it in black. Okay, I can get more than that, but I'm just going to do that one board. Here's what it says. I got one 12.5-inch black board. Add this to my parts list, and here it is in my shopping cart. Now, you can't change the quantity here because that previous form is where you do all that. All you can do here, if I want to get rid of this, is uncheck that. Now hit update. Now that board's gone. Okay, this is where you click to read about how my discount program works. If you see your name, your username up here, means you've already logged into the shopping cart. If you have got here and you haven't logged in, you go back to the cart and you can continue shopping, or you can just hit the back button. Well, okay, I didn't come from a regular page, but it's faster to go backwards. Go up here, log in here, like I showed you before. I'm going to go back to my shopping cart. Sorry, I had a dog knocking at the shop door, wanted in. All right, continue on here. Here's my sales history, my current discount. You can read how the discount program works here. It's better to save up your percentages and use it on a bigger order, because 10% of $1 is 10 cent discount. 10% of a $100 order is more. It's $10. So would you rather have $10 for the same percentage, or $1 off your order? Here's the shipping calculator. This is where you pick your shipping method. If you don't pick anything, it's going to be priority mail. I've already been here messing around. I'm showing express mail here. Let me show you how to change that. I'm going to put a zip code in here. Hit F12 by accident, I guess there. Okay, that's my zip code. It knows the weight of all the parts in the shopping cart. There's total grams there. It goes to the USPS site and gives you shipping estimates over here. And down here, see, I've already picked USPS Express Mail. I'm going to change this to back to Priority Mail, or let's just test it with you First Class Mail. If the package is parts are too heavy for First Class, you won't be able to select First Class. First Class has a maximum weight. So let's click here to submit my shipping method. And it's just giving you a confirmation that your current shipping method is First Class Mail. And you go back to your shopping cart here. And now see, my shipping method is First Class Mail. The shipping only includes the estimate. It only knows the weights of the parts. It does not know how much the final box is going to weigh. Boxes can vary in weight. Packing material inside can vary. So this shipping estimate it gave you on the previous page is just for the parts only. If it adds another 4 ounces to this first class order, because of the box, it's going to be more. Fortunately, first class is pretty cheap. Anyways, and there's the U.S. shipping calculator we just used. Here's where you pick other countries for shipping calculator. All right, if you hit continue shopping button here, it will go back to the previous page, which this was our previous page. But let's say we were in resistors. I'm going to add this resistor. Now, there it is. I added that 1 ohm resistor. I'm going to continue shopping. It'll go back to the same page. Pull this down. Let's go back and view our shopping cart again. Search parts catalog. That's pretty explanatory there. Restart your whole cart. This will empty the whole shopping cart. There'll be nothing in it, and you can start over. And if you were logged in, you'll see this down here. You can save a private parts list of all the items in the cart up here. So if you build a list of parts and you want to save it for future use, give it a name down here and save it. This only shows up if you've logged in. This table will not be here if you're just a guest. So let's check out. We're done with our list. Now we're in the checkout screen. And it gives you your sales history. And here's where you can apply your current discount or do not apply and save up. And well, your percentage will go up. And since I've already logged in and it knows me, it's filled out this form automatically. If you have not logged in, you're just a guest, you'll have to add all this information. And this wants to know if your shipping address is the same as a billing address, and it is. So I check that, and it fills out the shipping info. If it was different, I would go back and fill in, say I wanted to ship to my business where I work instead of my home address. But that's where you would fill that in. Payment type, here's where you fill in your credit card information, or PayPal, the only two types I accept. If you choose PayPal, you will get an email from me after you have checked out with a link to your PayPal invoice. You have to go to PayPal following that link and pay that invoice. You do not check out here with PayPal. I don't know what the final shipping is going to be, and shipping can vary quite a bit, so you have to wait for me to send you a PayPal invoice and after I know what the actual real shipping is. With credit cards, I'm just going to put the correct shipping on it and run it through, and your order gets packed up immediately. PayPal, I have to wait for you to pay before I do anything. So here, down here, it says your shipping method is USPS First Class Mail. That's because we picked it in the shopping cart. If you want to go back and change that, you can go here, and it takes you right back to your shopping cart. And you would use the shipping calculator to change that. Let's do that. Let's 90210 zip, say, and I want to change it to priority mail. I want it a little bit faster than first class. Now it's priority mail. Now I'm going to check out again. And you have to remember, since you're coming back to the screen, it's not going to remember the settings you had. So I don't want to apply my discount to this order. It's a tiny order. And I want it shipped to my home address. And I'm going to say PayPal. And now you could add a note here. Thanks. Thanks for everything. And then you submit this. This is not the final button. You have to look at everything here. And this is where people mess up all the time. They go so fast, they don't examine everything. Is this your correct email address? Is this shipping address okay? I've seen people check out and forget to put the house number there. I've seen people put the wrong part in the shopping cart, say they'll order some board, and they'll order something else that does not work with that board material. So look at everything real close here. And then, if everything is correct, this is how you finally submit the order by clicking this button. I'm not going to do it because this is a fake order. But that's exactly how my whole shopping cart works. I think I covered everything. Go back to my shopping cart here. And I believe I covered everything in the menus here. I'll just show you quickly what a mobile user's catalog looks like. See how it's compressed and switches, keeps everything in the middle so it shows up really nice on a mobile screen. Whereas on a regular desktop, you've got more real estate, so the whole width of the screen is utilized there. So there's the indexes, no matter where you're at. And that's how the shopping cart works.